If disaster strikes mid-Michigan, are local officials prepared to handle it? I'm here with Saginaw County Treasurer Tim Novak. Thank you so much for being with
us
today. Good morning. All right, so last Thursday, we were just talking about this. Really interesting. Yeah. There was a disaster drill at MBS Airport. Can you tell us what that was all about?
Yeah, so they simulated a plane coming from Las Vegas, and everybody got sick at a buffet, and so all these folks are coming in to the airport. And then the uniqueness of the airport is it's located in the middle of Bay Saginaw, Midland County. So how do we respond? So we had the health departments and the emergency management centers from all three counties. The airport was involved in the medical facility. So it's kind of like this, you know, how do you, on the surface of it, they're handling the disaster out on the tarmac or where the airplane comes in. And then all of the organizations, the hospitals, and the rest of us were in law enforcement. We're in a room kind of talking through, like, what would we be doing now if we, as we got the alerts? And it was interesting to hear the different perspectives from the different organizations and different expertises. What would we be doing at the time?
Very interesting. So how does that drill like this help the community prepare for an emergency?
Well, I think that the cool thing was is kind of figuring out what everybody's role was going to be and how respectful everybody was of the different people's expertise, and even like the three hospitals all had to get together, and would there be one spokesman amongst the three of them, and what would the unifying message be amongst everybody? And then of course the curveballs always were like, we're planning this little perfect response, and I was like, oh, but social media probably would have released it, and somebody was pretending that a Facebook Live video was filming this as we're here in the back room trying to generate our message, and how do you respond to that? And would your organization had already had responded before we got together in our little, you know, our little focus group? So it was neat to talk through this. And we do, you know, one big exercise every year, and there was a lot of talk afterwards about smaller groups getting together and talking their way through how would we handle this? Because really, you know, you don't want to create panic amongst the public, but you also want to make sure that folks are safe, and is it go to the emergency rooms or don't go to the emergency rooms, and how do you handle traffic flow?
Yeah.
It was really eye-opening. It was my first experience, so for me, I was probably the neophyte in the room. It's like, oh my gosh.
But you learn a lot.
Yeah, it was really interesting, and everybody was, and then WNEM was there afterwards and did the mock press conference. Mm-hmm. So they kind of walked through and put the folks that were on the hot seat up there and asked a lot of different questions, and it was a neat experience. I think folks, everybody came away feeling better about where we're at and knowing that we have room to improve, and that's a good thing.
You know, you mentioned that everyone played their role and played it well. What was your role in this drill?
My role was to help generate a message on behalf of Saginaw County, like what would the county's role in this kind of be? And it was kind of like the synergy afterwards. You know, the health professionals are going to handle their piece, the law enforcement are going to handle theirs, and the county was like, you know, everybody, the summary afterwards, this is what folks should feel good about. And then, you know, what do we set up an assistance center for families? That was kind of the county's role. That would have been the piece of it. You know, how do we bring families together to make sure that they're getting the information and that kind of stuff? So
you learn a lot. Hopefully we don't ever need to use
it. We don't ever want to use that stuff.
Right, but we know what to do now if that happened. Well, thank you so much for being with us today. And if you have any questions to ask the county, make sure you send those to WNEM at WNEM.com.